bringing you Thailand's insights, direction, stability, prosperity, and sustainability. Let's get inside. Gain the insight with the insider.
Sadikap, and welcome to the insider. Over the past few years, the government has issued several measures and policies to help boost our economy. There are many infrastructure projects and emergence of many new special economic zones, SME supporting measures, and last but not least, the one which is considered to be another engine to help drive growth. It is called Thailand 4.0. Today we are going to talk more about it to see what it is, how it works, with our special guest, Dr. Sawit Mesingsi, Deputy Commerce Minister, who will introduce the concept of Thailand 4.0.
Sadikap.
Yep.
What is Thailand 4.0?
Put it this way, I think the change from the 20th century toward the 21st century is provide the new set of opportunity, the new set of threats, as well as a new set of constraints and also capabilities for every country. So I'll take a look at US. They're also launching the campaign so-called the Nation of Maker. The same for the UK. They also have Innovate UK. So no doubt to talk about South Korea. They have the creative economy. And also India, they are also talking about Make in India. So the same for Thailand. I think it's time for us to transform our country in order to fit with the 21st century. And this is the strategic intent of our Prime Minister. We start with Thailand 1.0.
Yes.
At that time, we are the agrarian society. Also, we make and sell, you know, many agricultural products. So most of them are commodities. And then we're trying to capture the trend of industrialization. So we move from Thailand 1.0 to Thailand 2.0, with this more focus on light industry. So based on our comparative advantage that we have abundance of resources, but also we also have a cheap labor cost. And after that, due to the globalization, which comprise the free flow of goods and services, as well as free flow of capital and technology, then we turn ourselves from 2.0 to 3.0, which is more focusing on heavy industry and more sophisticated product. Even though the Thailand 3.0 contribute a lot to our country economy prosperity, but they also have a lot of negative consequences, at least three traps. To avoid or escape from these three traps into the new landscape, so-called Thailand 4.0.
You also mentioned about South Korea, which not long ago, we see South Korea is a developing country, but it is changed now. South Korea has changed a lot, changed a great deal in all areas. So is this the same kind of model that we are going to transform Thailand into our new future?
Oh, it's a very good question. Put it this way, every country has their own path to development for Thailand as well. Now, I think our challenge is about these three traps, right? How to escape from these three traps. So this is the reason why Thailand 4.0 was starting with building and embedding the new engine for growth. We have three engines for growth. To escape from the middle income trap, we need to have the competitive growth engine. Put it this way, is how can we shift from more for less to be less for more, or focusing on instead of commodity to be more innovative product. This is the first engine that I'd like to address in Thailand 4.0. The second one is to escape from the inequality trap. We need the inclusive growth engine. How can we leave no one behind? So the second important thing in line with the innovation-driven economy is about inclusive society. And the third one, to escape from the imbalance traps, we need to have a green growth engine. So this one, the Prime Minister always talking about the sustainable development goals. So this is, I think, is aimed for building in such a way that you're towards what we call the sustainable growth and development. So this is three engines. So this is unique for Thailand. The underlying philosophy behind these three engines is the sufficiency economy philosophy. Because of what? We need to balance. Beforehand, we put everything in economic well at the expense of the rest. I think Thailand 4.0 trying to, you know, decode or translate these three ambitious goals of the government: stability, prosperity, and sustainability into action. And as we know that, you know, we are in the process of trying to reform our country. So how can you make the reform in action? So Thailand 4.0 is the model that put at least three top prioritize the reform initiative. So it's comprised at least three main components of reform initiative. The first one is economic reform. Transform our country from efficiency driven to a more innovation driven economy. But at the same time, we also have to revamp our research and development, because, you know, this is we are now achieving towards more brain based. We need to have the knowledge, create the knowledge community, the knowledge society. So this is the second reform. The third one, inevitable, is about reform our people, reform our education. So Thailand 4.0 in the context of reform is comprised at least three reform initiatives.
What would be the new engine of growth in order to become Thailand 4.0, and of course to achieve the less for more concept?
The most important is our people. This is why our Prime Minister always said that, you know, to pursuit to Thailand 4.0, we need Thai people 4.0 first, right? So education is a very important thing. Put it this way, our Prime Minister always talking about, you know, how can we change our traditional farmer into the smart farmers? How can we change our traditional SME to be more smart enterprise, or what we call innovation-driven entrepreneurs, at the same for our worker from the low skill or semi-skill towards more high skill labor. So I think the primary focus of Thailand 4.0 is not the sector, it's about the people. We have to change our people. So how can we make our, you know, Thai people to be more actively and engaged people? This is a kind of democratization, right? So to make them more actively engaged, it means that, okay, we have to change the Thai people from Thai to be global Thai. The second one is from analog Thai to be more digital Thai, right? And the same for the, you know, incompetent Thai to be more capable Thai, as well as from the, you know, self-centric, selfish Thai to be more like a, you know, socially responsible Thai.
If I am the private sectors, or if I am the ordinary people, what should I prepare? How should I prepare myself in order to serve this objective of the government, in order to make Thailand become Thailand 4.0?
As I just mentioned that, you know, Thailand 4.0 is a people-centric. So it's starting with people, but it's not like a populist policy that, okay, this is the set of things that the government like to provide or give it to people, right? The keyword for Thailand 4.0 is about empowering people to uplift the capability of the people. So I think what we're trying to do is, everyone have to change the mindset, have to believe that, you know, they are the active citizen, they are the engaged citizen. Now, most of the people in Thailand, most of them are still passive citizens. So they don't know the potential. So what the government have to do is unlock the constraint. So we're starting with, you know, growth for people, to provide growth so that they can grow. And then, you know, after we unlock the constraint, I quite believe that they will unleash their own potential. And at that time, they will turn from growth for people to be for people for growth. So this is all the thing that I think is, it takes time, but it start with attitude of the people. It start with the belief. It's not a top-down mandate. It's just showing the the strong belief or the strategic intent of our government and also our Prime Minister. But when we, as I just said, that it's a social movement, so it should be the bottom-up process. So this is the reason why education or investing in people is very important thing in Thailand 4.0 model.
I have my attitude ready. Mm. I know that I have to move, I have to change, I have to move on. Yeah. But I don't know my potential. Mm-hmm. I need government to play a facilitator role, mm-hmm, in identifying the potential, mm-hmm, of of the Thai people,
yes.
of the Thai society,
uh-huh.
of the country.
Yes.
What would you say?
I'll put it this way. For Thailand, when we're talking about people, Thai people 4.0 is a goal. Because now we have the people 1.0, 2.0, and 3.0, right? The poor farmer, including the old toppers and also the, you know, turnaround SME, including the poor people in the city, and as well as the aging people. So I think this is, most of them are still the Thai people 1.0. They need some help, right? And this is the way that we're trying to, you know, how can we, you know, enhance or create the opportunity for them to increase their revenue or to reduce their burdens, particularly the expenses, and also how can we uplift their quality of life. This is the first group for Thailand 1.0 that we trying to do, to tackle their, you know, like a burden. And this is the kind of their own constraint. That we relieve this, and then, you know, they will end up with unleashing their potential. But the second group, I think what this government trying to do is create the society with opportunity. Now the government trying to do is have a campaign to reskill, to upskill, and also to multi-skill them. So in order to for them to have a better life and 3.0 people, I think the 3.0 have a lot of opportunity. So how can we make them like strong enough? Put what I call is the power to innovate in order for them to compete with their counterpart in the world. This is a kind of startup or any kind of innovation-driven enterprise. So put it this way, what we are trying to do is we separate people into different groups, the 1.0, and what is the challenge, and how can we, you know, helping them. The for Thailand 2.0, right? How can we create more opportunity? I think two things we have to do is create the society with opportunity as well as the society with competence. So give them, you know, more skill or uplifting them. And the third one is the globally competitive Thai. How can make them more strong and then be the spearhead to have a foothold in the global market. And then, you know, under the principle of left no one behind, when they have a footprint in the global market, then they will, you know, hand in hand with SME 2.0 or SME 1.0 and get together.
One particular issue that this government has emphasized most of the time, that is the sustainable development or sustainability.
Yes.
The guiding principle that this philosophy of the sufficiency economy,
yes.
How that philosophy would help Thailand to become Thailand 4.0?
What we really need for Thailand, I think, is the humanistic capitalism. So it's about human being. So I think the sufficiency economy is answering this challenge, right? So it means that, okay, you need a balance. You are in the world of interdependence. So you need to balance, right? You balance between knowledge and morality. You also have to balance between self and other. So for me, the sufficiency economy is the balance between the self-interest and also the public interest. So this one for Thailand 4.0, we are not just talking about, you know, make our country rich or make our people rich, but how can we make it like a distributed capitalism?
Well, thank you very much, Excellency. Time really flies. You know, it is a very serious issue, but talking to you make it very enjoyable conversation and very informative. Well, thank you very much for being with the Insider. Sawasdee krap. Today we have listened a lot of new ideas and very interesting information about where we are heading to. And I am confident that the Thailand 4.0 policy would help to boost our economy and help Thailand to become a sustainable society. Well, thank you for watching The Insider, and please stay tuned for the next episode. And for this week, thank you once again, and Sawasdee krap.